This is a tutorial project to give an example of how to organize your code into classes, so that it would be more manageable in the long run. We have this little traffic light with green, yellow and red LEDs, and our goal is to make it functional. Let's start with defining the LED pins. Set the pins as output. And for a simple test, let's just flash those LEDs one by one. Let's test it. Now the LEDs are blinking one by one. As you can see, this is really low level code, but we want to make it more abstract. So what we can do is create a new class for traffic light. New tab, traffic light. And create a class for it. Let's create a constructor that takes the LED pins as parameters. And store those parameters as internal variables for the class. Now that we have a class for the traffic light, we can do all the initialization inside the class. So we can set the pin modes inside the constructor of the class. And we can move lighting the LEDs inside the class as properly named methods. Method green turns the traffic light into green. Yellow lights up the yellow LED. Red lights up red LED. And a method that turns all the LEDs off. So green lights up green, yellow lights up yellow, and red lights up red. And off turns everything off. And now we can create the object for the traffic light. And instead of those low-level digital writes, we can have those human-readable commands. Of course, we also have to include our class. And let's try it out. Okay, we have missing type parameter here. It's identical to the first example, but it is much more clear in the main loop. Next step is to add a button, so that the light can react to that. Let's define the pin, and at first let's initialize it in the main file. The goal here is to simulate the pedestrian traffic light button, so that if someone presses the button, the traffic light for the cars will go red. The first step is really primitive. As long as the button is held down, it will be red, and the moment it is released, it will go back to green. But as you can see, this is also a really low-level function call. We want it to be more abstract, so we create a new class for the button. Constructor with the button pin. And again, we can initialize the button inside the constructor. And create a Boolean function that returns if the button is pressed or not. Let's try to compile it. Class definitions have to end with a semicolon. Okay, I have to fix this. I had a mistake in the constructor name. And now when we compile it, it does the same thing as before, but it's much more readable in the main loop. We abstracted away the digital read and the fact that the button signal was inverted. Actually, we do not want the light to turn red and green directly. We want those lights to go red or green as the proper lighting cycle is. So instead of red and green, we make new functions, stop and go. Since the light cycles need some processing, we have to create a loop inside the traffic light class so it can do its thing. Since we do not need access to those methods outside of the class, we can make them private. And we create new public methods, go, stop and loop. Go means initially red, then it goes to yellow and then to green. Stop means first it's green, then it is blinking green, then it's yellow, and then it is red. We must build a state machine inside the traffic light. So let's define all the states. It has green, blinking green, yellow, and red. And the class should have its current state. Initialize it to green by default. And the target state. If target state differs from the current state, then it goes to the cycle and initialize the default green. Go means that the target state is green. And stop means that the target state is red. And in the main loop, we have to check what is the target. If the target state is green, then go to green, otherwise go to red. We have to check what the current state is and then move on to the next state. Let's start with go to red. If it's green, we have to go to blinking green. So current state equals blinking green. But we also want to set the timer for the blinking green. It has to blink, let's say, 3 seconds. Timer blinking green, 3 seconds. We have to create the method for the timer, so start timer. Timer blinking green. Time in milliseconds, we want to wait. We need to store the timer state. So timer start equals current time in milliseconds. And timer target is the time we want to wait. And then another method to check if the timer is ready. We just check if the target time has passed. So when the state is green, we set the current state to blinking and then start timer with 3 seconds. In the blinking screen, we have to blink green and then check if the timer is ready. Then switch over to the next state. But similarly as the previous step, the yellow has a timeout. Let's make it 2 seconds. And also we have to define the blinking green. Let's make it so that it's 500 milliseconds off and 500 milliseconds on. And in the yellow case, just activate the yellow light. And if the timer is ready, then set current state to red. And since red is our end goal, just activate the red light and do nothing. Go to green to the more logical order. If it is red, set the current state to yellow. And start timer for the yellow light. Activate yellow light, and if timer is ready, go to green. since we do not need blinking green, we just switch it over to green. And here just activate the green light. Now let's check if it compiles. I'm missing comma. Missing type. As you can see, it works. The only problem is that you have to hold the button. The moment you release the button, it will go back to green. But we want to make it so that you press the button and it goes to red and it turns back to green after some time. So we have to modify the main loop. We want to use a timer again, as inside the traffic light. So to avoid re-implementing the same code, we move the timer logic to its own class. Make a new class. Timer start and timer target. And two methods. Start timer and this timer ready. Now inside the traffic light, we can make a timer object. We have to also include it. And every time we start the timer, we just do it to the object. And let's try to compile. Now we can use the same timer inside the main loop. But now there is a problem. We include the timer twice. We also include it here. And this creates a compilation error that the timer is defined twice. For that, we have to use include guards in the header files. This means if not defined, the file name. Timer H. Then define it. Fine. And at the end of the file, and if, and we should do it for all the header files. And it compiles fine. And in the main loop, we can create a new timer. When the button is pressed, we can start the timer. Let's say 10 seconds. And when the button is released, we do not set go before the timer has ended. As you can see, now if you press the button, it goes through the go and stop cycle. And after 10 seconds has passed, it will go back to go automatically. And now the main loop is really easy to read. As you can see, it just checks if button is pressed, then commands the traffic light to go to stop mode, starts a timer, and if button is not pressed, then if the timer is ready, it goes back to go. All the complexity of what it means to go to red or go to green is hidden inside the traffic light class. If you want to change it, you can do it here, but it does not pollute the main loop. Additionally, you can make the button class more complex, the bounce filters or stuff like that. And now it is really simple to add a separate set of LEDs for the second traffic light.